Make or Fake an HRI for IVL in Bryce for Bryce. Part 2, Rendering the Exposure Series. Now we have the scene as discussed in Part 1 and can render the panorama. In photography, we need a series of exposures with different settings that control the light reaching the film or sensor. For Bryce, we need a series of renders under different light. We have to establish what lights we have, what intensities those lights have, and also consider the 2D faces that emulate the light sources. Once we know what we have, we can determine how we have to change the values between the renders and how many renders we will need. Each scene will have different lighting, and you will have to create a table for each setup. This table is only valued for my scene. Bryce does not need the f-stop column, but programs that merge exposures to an HRI do. F1 is an ideal camera and does not exist in reality, but the programs accept it and it is easiest to start with this value. F2 has the aperture 1 full f-stop smaller, that is, the sensor gets half the light of F1. F4 gives half the light of F2 and a fourth of F1. Equally, F8 results in an eighth and F16 in a sixteenth of the light of F1. There are two groups of spotlights in the scene, denoted A and B, in this table. Their diffuse value is halved for each full f-stop down, 1500, 250, 125, 64. These are halved to begin with, 500, 250, 125, 64 and 32. Then there are two filler radials with no shadow casting and no fall-off. Their diffuse value is also halved, but beyond F4, we cannot half diffuse again because only integer values can be entered. Therefore, we set the color from white to mid-gray. White, mid-gray, which also halves the light, and then again to dark gray, 64, which halves the light yet again. The white 2D faces are what is interpreted as the brightness of the light sources. We can change the white for ambient and diffuse to some gray shades as we did for the radials. But here we do not follow the pattern of halving brightness by making the white progressively gray, because if we did, here we have the blue curve, they would not stand out as brighter than the rest, as we have on the red curve. We want them as light sources in the HRI. The whiteness stays the same for F1 and 2, which will be interpreted as overexposed parts. Only at F4, the white gets a bit grey, but only a fourth from 255 to 192, not half. This is the method we use to make the light sources stand out. Finally, we decide which settings should be rendered. If we save the renders as 24-bit BMP, we would need all 5 renders. However, we will export the rendered images as 48-bit TIFF, and the brightness resolution is high enough to use exposures with 2 full f-stops apart, resulting in a render time saving of 40%. We will only use the green ones. For this scene, I did render all settings, exported them as 48-bit TIFF and created 2 light probes, one including the 5 at 1 full f-stop and the other only including the 3 at 2 f-stops apart. There is a small difference which can be measured but is hardly noticeable. The HRI with the 1 f-stop renders is less bright, but has slightly better light resolution. This test renders can be considered as a sundial and show the direction of the prominent light by the direction of the shadows cast and their respective brightness by the shadow intensity. This one uses all five renders and is 1/3 of a f-stop less bright than this one, which only uses three renders. The brightness difference was compensated by the HRI effect setting, which could be reduced from 523 to 325. There is also a small difference of around 1 degree in the shadow direction. This is shown here. The green fringe comes from the left render and the red fringe from the center one. As observed before, the difference is so small that it does not justify a 40% longer render. Here are the renders. F1 render, 48-bit TIFF used for the HRI. F2 render, 48-bit TIFF also, but not used for the HRI. F4 render, 48-bit TIFF used for the HRI. F8 render, not used for the HRI. And F16 render, used for the HRI. Up to now, we exported the renders as 48-bit TIFF and used them to merge to an HRI. We also proved that we can use renders with the lights in two full f-stop increments, and we can save us the trouble to render in one f-stop increment. Now what happens if we save the renders as conventional 24-bit TIFF or BMP and use those renders to assemble an HRI? Again, I rendered in one f-stop increment and assembled two HRIs. This one takes all the five renders exported or saved as BMP, and this one only used the three renders and saved as BMP. The one made with five BMPs looks almost the same as the one made with three 48-bit TIFFs, but the one made with only three BMPs has completely wrong colors and also wrong light. This HRI created from 5 BMPs looks nearly the same as the one made from 5 48-bit TIFFs, but is less bright by about a 1/4 f-stop and about 1 full f-stop less bright than the one made from 3 48-bit TIFFs. It is acceptable nevertheless, but 5 renders are needed. The HRI made from 3 BMPs is 12 times brighter than the one made from 3 48-bit TIFFs, and the colors are completely wrong. This test with the BMPs demonstrates clearly that exporting the renders as 48-bit TIFFs and using renders in two full f-stop intervals is the way to go. It gives the best result, and the renders need the least of time. Now, since this is settled for good, we will look how to export the rendered image as 48-bit TIFF. But first, we have to make sure that the render options are correctly set. Gamma correction, off. 48-bit dithering, off. 360-degree panoramic projection, on. Gamma correction renders the render useless for using it for assembling an HRI because it changes the linearity of the light intensities. 48-bit dithering is cool and should be enabled if the render is saved as a conventional 24-bit image like BMP. However, if the render is exported as a 48-bit TIFF, dithering does add noise and moire, and it should therefore be disabled. And 360-degree panoramic projection is mandatory if the spherical mapper is used. We export the render the moment the rendering process finishes as 48-bit TIFF. Now, why 48-bit TIFF and not 96-bit HDR or OpenXR? Simple. We want to merge the renders on HDRI. An HDRI file cannot be merged on HDRI. Only low dynamic range images, LDRIs, can be merged to a high dynamic range image. Modern DSLR cameras also can save the shots in more than 24-bit color resolution if a RAW format is used. Therefore, HDRI-capable programs can read and merge 24 and 48-bit images to an HDRI. To export the rendered image, remember, right after rendering finished, before you do anything else, click on File, Export Image. This opens the Save As dialog. Use as file type TIFF and the format 48 bits per pixel. After the next render, the file type TIFF is already selected, but the format here falls back to 24 bits per pixel. So please pay attention, otherwise you have to render again. Give the file a name that helps you identify which exposure the render represents. I usually add the f-stop number. It is important to know which image is which when you go about assembling the HDRI, because there are no EXIF data embedded as in a photograph. So this concludes the second part. In the third and last part, we will merge the rendered panoramas to an HDRI.